your legs and your feet?
I went on a 5-day holiday, and if the bed isn't a hard bed,
yeah,
I end up with a trap sciatic nerve.
Right, okay.
And I was walking about with 2 sticks,
yeah,
the rest of the week. Oh. Over there.
Oh,
but it's a soft bed.
Yeah, yeah.
And it was a deep mattress.
Yeah.
But it went all the way down.
Yeah.
To the base.
Oh no, that's not good, eh?
And I just.
And so, are you in constant pain with this? Is it all the time?
I have no pain now, but yeah. I have trouble with my feet.
The feet.
From that.
Right. Is it just that side or both feet?
Both feet.
Both feet. Yeah. Okay. So that's what I'm going to be working on. Now, so the way the healing works is this. I wear white so that anything that gets pulled out of Joyce, so that the guides that work with me can see like a grey cloud in my energy and it not contaminate me. And it's not so long ago your doctors and nurses wore white. Yeah, I remember nurses and doctors wore starched white uniforms, didn't they? And it wasn't just for cleanliness to show they were clean, it was for spiritual protection. All right. So, as much as Joyce has said the problems with her feet, they're starting with her head. There's nothing wrong with your head in that sense, Joyce, eh?
A bit lower down than it.
All right. Now that sound was put straight down the crown, straight the way down to the spine, to the very base of the spine, the tailbone, the coccyx. So though my hands are up at Joyce's head, one on the shoulder, one on the head, the sound has been put again down Joyce's front, down to the tailbone again, and then back up again. Now, Joyce, just notice how your feet are feeling, because I'm curious to know if that sound has actually started working on your feet. Just notice how they're feeling.
I'm feeling a bit warm.
I'm feeling warm. Right.
Which is unusual.
Right. Just try walking around and see how your feet feel. You can take your stick with you for now. Is there any pain there at the moment?
Not pain, no.
Well, that's good then, isn't it? Right. Have a sit down. So what they've done, you've noticed that it was sciatic pain, but then it went into your feet. Mm-hmm. And all they've done, they've put sound down at the back, and then they've put sound down and back up at the front. But just notice, is there any pain at all?
Stiffness
now.
Yeah.
Okay. Well, I'm going to go back here. My brain thinks I should kneel down and work on the feet, but the guides have just walked me back here again. So the feet is the symptom, but the underlying cause isn't the feet, it's still in the spine. With me is just saying to me, we collectively as a species, we have much to learn about these bodies. We have much to learn about these bodies in all different senses, about how we can use these bodies, about how we can look after these bodies, about nutrition, about energy that can flow through these bodies. Okay, now he's just suggesting in my mind's eye, he's showing me just to place my hands on Joyce's left shoulder this time. And Joyce, I'm just going to get you to put your awareness into your feet. There's a saying by the Buddha which is along the lines of, foot doesn't know foot until foot touches the earth. If you hold your foot in midair, you can't really feel foot. You can feel the aliveness in there, but when your feet touches the earth, then, and feels a connection with the earth, then we feel foot. Now, how are your feet feeling, Joyce?
Warmer.
Warmer, that's good, isn't it? Your feet aren't normally warm, eh?
No.
Even in this weather? So that means circulation and blood flow is getting through there again, which is good. Now, are you also feeling quite peaceful?
Yeah.
Yeah, that's good. There's a lovely, the spirit that's working with me at the moment is a very, very peaceful saint. Who's in no hurry whatsoever to do the healing. Which is probably why we've got a small audience tonight. Alright, now it's being suggested that I get you to try walking around again. Notice how your feet feel. To apparently your knees. You haven't mentioned your knees, but you've got problems with your knees. Does that make sense?
Yeah.
Yeah. All right, so even though I'm a good distance from the knees, he's going to work on the knees. We'll know your knees are better when you get up out of the chair easier. Yeah?
I've got the knees done.
Ah. Well, they could have done a better job, apparently. So this surgeon will work on... when we've had bits of our body, hips or knees, replaced by physical surgeons, physical doctors, they will fine-tune what those physical surgeons have done and make them better. Now, your right knee feels worse than your left. Walk. All right. Just try standing up and see how that feels, Joyce. Better, isn't it? How's it feeling?
Okay.
Feels all right. No pain in your knees?
No.
No?
No.
No? Any stiffness in there?
I did have a lot of stiffness.
But has it gone now?
Yeah.
Yeah, well, that's all right, isn't it? Right. Now, let's try you walking around and see if you can walk without your stick, just out of curiosity. I'll look after that for you. Yeah. You're getting up nicer. Now what we've got to do, we've got to work on your back. Because you've been walking with your stick, you've started to bring yourself forward. Alright, so I'm gonna get you just to stand up a little bit longer for me. And I'm just going to work on your back. Alright, I want you to face that way. And we should get a really good side view of this. Alright. Sound gets used in different ways. Sometimes it's sonar to give me information about what's in the body. On this occasion, the sound doesn't sound pure. The sound that went in through Joyce's top of the head and came back out again, that was a really pure sound. This has got like a kind of a sound in it. So that means there's stuff in the shoulders and in the neck that needs to be released. The sounds you hear me make are made by the spirit doctors working through me. All that happened was a few years ago, lying in bed in a motel room, one of my guides asked me, "How long can you hold your breath?" I said, "Go away." They said, "How long can you hold your breath?" I said, "Go away." "How long can you hold your breath?" "Go away." "How long can you hold your breath?" "Get lost." "How long can you hold your breath?" "I don't know." "How long can you hold your breath?" "I don't know." "How long can you hold your breath?" "Go away." "How long can you hold your breath?" And in the end I went, and I could hold my breath for 45 seconds. The next day, the healing started, sound healing started coming through me. Now, I know you did just say you wanted your feet to, like, but the surgeon can't let you go away with that lump of energy in you. And there we go. Try walking around again, Joyce, see how that feels.
A lot better.
Marks out of 10 for the surgeon, then what would you give him?
I lost a bit of my balance.
You'd lost some of your balance, yeah? Are you feeling good now?
Yeah.
Yeah? Walk a bit further, just make sure it's not a fluke. We can actually see her hips moving now from side to side as she's walking. Yeah, just tell the camera at home. That's it.
Feels a lot great.
Awesome. There you go. And the spirits will keep on working on you as you sit in the audience as well. You're probably going to grow an inch by the end of tonight. Give her a round of applause.